Google just launched vibe coding inside AI Studio, and it might be the most practical AI development tool they have shipped yet. The pitch is dead simple. You describe an app in plain English and Gemini builds it right in front of you, live, with no setup required. No API hunting, no environment wrestling, just straight to working code. The early demos are already turning heads. One prompt spun up a fully functional video generator powered by voice commands. Another created an image editing tool using computer vision. A third built a content writing assistant hooked directly into Google Search. All of this happens in real time while Gemini handles the complicated back-end wiring you would normally spend hours figuring out. It feels effortless, which is exactly the point. Here's where it gets interesting. Vibe. Coding is not just about generating a Hello World app and calling it a day. The real power shows up in annotation mode, and this is the feature. That changes how you actually build. Normally, when you want to tweak something visual, you hunt through component files, CSS classes, and config settings just to change a button color or adjust some padding. It breaks your flow every single time. With annotation mode, you highlight the element on screen and tell Gemini what you want. Make this header bolder. Slide this image in from the right. Tighten up the spacing between these cards. The system translates your plain language into precise code changes and applies them instantly. You are not context switching between designer brain and developer brain anymore. You are just shaping the thing you are building in real time, like sculpting clay. And because every change happens immediately, you stack up wins fast. That momentum matters. It is the difference between spending a bad Saturday afternoon building something cool versus spending it debugging why your CSS grid will not cooperate. Both beginners and experienced developers benefit here. New builders get past the technical walls that usually stop them. Experienced devs skip the boring repetitive tasks and focus on the creative decisions that actually matter. The app gallery got a complete makeover too. It is no longer a boring list of templates you ignore. Now it is a visual library where every project is something you can preview, fork, and remix. The starter code is designed to teach you as you build. So you are learning patterns instead of copy-pasting mystery code from Stack Overflow. And if you are staring at a blank screen with no idea where to start, there is an I am feeling lucky button that drops you into a viable project immediately. Sometimes you just need momentum to get going. There is also a clever detail most people will miss at first. While your app is building, Gemini runs a brainstorming session in the background. The loading screen is not wasted time anymore. It drops contextual suggestions, alternative layouts, animation ideas, little feature tweaks you might not have considered. The first time you see it, it feels like a nice touch. By the third or fourth project, you realize it is actually changing how you think about building. Downtime becomes creative time. Now here is the practical bit that matters for anyone who actually ships projects. When you hit your free usage quota, most demos just stop. Game over until tomorrow. Vibe. Coding lets you drop in your own API keys and keep building. Then when your free tier resets, it switches you back automatically. No artificial stopping points, no momentum killers. You decide when to stop, not the quota system. There is a second feature launching alongside Vibe Coding that fits the same philosophy. Canvas slides inside Gemini can now generate full presentation decks from your documents, spreadsheets, or research papers. You are not getting generic templates. You are getting themed decks grounded in your actual content, with relevant images and clean layouts. Export directly to Google Slides and keep editing. It works on personal and workspace accounts, which matters because students in small teams should not hit artificial walls for basic tools. Think about the full workflow this enables. You build a feature using vibe coding. You need to explain it to your team or present it to a client. You feed your documentation into Canvas. Get a polished deck in minutes. Tune the two or three slides that need your specific touch and share it. The whole cycle from idea to shippable artifact to presentation happens in one ecosystem with way less friction. Google is making a specific bet here. They are betting that the future of building software is less about memorizing syntax and fighting with toolchains and more about directing a capable system that handles the mechanical stuff. Vibe coding and Canvas are not trying to replace developers. They are trying to remove the parts of development that drain time without adding value. The boring parts, the repetitive parts, The why am I Googling this again parts, and that bet feels right. We are watching the barrier to entry drop, while the ceiling for what you can build stays high. More people can start. Experienced people can move faster. The quality bar goes up because you spend more energy on what matters and less on plumbing. So what does this mean for you? If you have been sitting on an app idea but the technical lift felt too heavy, this might be your moment. If you build for a living, and you are tired of wiring the same patterns over and over, this could buy back hours every week. And if you are just curious about where AI assisted, development is heading, vibe coding is showing you the shape of it right now. This is not some distant future concept. It is live in AI Studio today. And based on what developers are already building with it, we are just seeing the beginning. The question is not whether tools like this will change how apps get made. The question is how fast. Jump in, try it, and see what you can build. Because the gap between I have an idea and I ship the thing just got a whole lot smaller. That is the shift worth paying attention to. So, what do you think? Is vibe coding actually the future of building apps? Leave a comment, hit subscribe. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next one.